Сьогодні війна вийшла за територію України.
Right now the sun's coming up and the emergency crew has restarted its actions here. I'm not sure if they're waiting on inspectors to come before they start removing the bodies and the debris.
These are emergency service personnel who've been on the scene for a couple of hours this morning. As you can see, they're holding sticks with white cloth on the top of it. They're marking bodies.
The fields are burnt and in them there are bodies and body parts, and they're strewn over a large area of land around here. There's fighting taking place, what, about 10 kilometers away from here. We can hear the booming taking place. So it's a difficult crime scene, and it's going to be very difficult for the investigators to get in here and do their work.
We assess Malaysian Airlines Flight 17 was likely downed by a surface-to-air missile, an SA-11, operated from a separatist-held location in eastern Ukraine.
Прекрасно, пусть предоставляют документы, и будем смотреть, какой это пуст, чей это пуст.
When you, Marie, and other officials were talking about missiles, along with tanks, going from Russia into Ukraine to supply the separatists, did those missiles include SA-11?
I don't think we have specified to that level of detail, Matt.
Нет, самолет не был сбит ополченцами, и это достаточно очевидно. Ополчение не располагает средствами ПВО, которые позволили бы сбить этот самолет.
You don't have any information to share with us with about whether you even know for sure that SA-11s were in?
I don't have any specific information about a Buk system making that transit. We're not ruling anything in or out at this point.
Today, tragedy proves again that the terrorism is not local, but global issue. Russia's aggression against Ukraine is not only our problem, but a threat for European and global security.
The Ukrainians do have SA-11 systems in their inventory. However, we are not aware of any Ukrainian SAM systems in the area of the shootdown.
We need to point out that the Russian authorities have, and the Defense Ministry particularly, has said this morning that it picked up radar transmissions from a Ukrainian missile site at the time that this tragedy happened.
Я вам напомню основной принцип римского права, который действует и сейчас. Кому выгодно это? Выгоден этот сбитый самолет?
This is the crime against humanity. All red lines have been already crossed. This is the deadline.
Когда я думаю об этой ситуации, мне вспоминаются слова господина Порошенко о том, что готовит для ополчения сюрприз.
What really jumped out at me and disgusts me, if I may, is today you saw already looters at the scene.
I actually didn't see any looters at the scene myself, to be completely honest.
Кого не сбивали? Видите?
Well, we're going to go back tonight's this evening and write up what we saw and what we heard.
There has to be order reestablished very, very quickly. Those bodies are decomposing, as I said. There's a lot of firepower, and I should add also that we also heard what sounded like missile fire in the background.
Basically, this is the territory which is not under our control, but we do hope that soon everything will be under the control of Ukrainian authorities with the assistance of Ukrainian army.
The Ukrainian government claims that rebels basically carried out some kind of a drive-by shooting in the area, but the video, the images we see, do not look like small arms fire killed these civilians. It looks like it was, again, some kind of artillery, and this taking place today.
Куда? За що нам таке горе? За що?
Скорая, 40 минут.
Це Порошенку глотку йому треба запхати ось сюди.
This is all going on as there are calls right now for a demilitarized zone around the crash site for international investigators to be able to go in. It is a very, very chaotic situation where people and civilians continue to die, even in the hours after this plane went down.
Приїхали, от люди видять, стоять люди в панике, они успокаивают, рассказывают, так и так, все хорошо, будет, сейчас вас соберут, эвакуируют. Они, блин, стараются нас, нам помочь, спасти.
Сегодня в полчетвертого утра приблизительно нефтеперерабатывающий завод был обстрелян системами ГРАД Украинской национальной гвардии.
Никакого вреда не представляет, в нем находится шрапнель, он когда разрывается, вылетает больше сотни шариков, которые разлетаются.
The least the president can do is to make a damn decision for once in his life. Announce that we are now going to supply lethal weapons to assist the Ukrainians in defending themselves and in completing the offensive that is now going on in eastern Ukraine to actually destroy the rebel insurgents.
Well, Charles, a moment ago, you said a minute ago that the Ukrainian army has performed well. And guess who's back in the Ukrainian army? It's our CIA, it's our government, it's the Europeans that the president has mobilized.
Необходимо беспристрастное открытое расследование случившегося. Не следует оказывать давление на такое расследование, пытаясь предрешать его итоги громкими заявлениями и необоснованными инсинуациями.
We intercepted a number of phone calls and we intercepted a number of messages in the internet.
The engagement of a range of countries and organizations, I think, in our view, makes it an international process, but of course Ukraine would have the lead in the investigation.
And the final say in the outcome of the investigation is in terms of ascriptions of culpability and so forth.